On the Medical Watch, let's talk about at-home COVID tests.
It's being called a critical next phase in managing the pandemic. President Biden plans to supply 500 million kits to Americans beginning in January. Medical reporter Dina Bearer has more on how they work and whether the rapid technology can detect the latest variants.
We saw the technology in action earlier this year at Abbott.
If you're positive, you end up with two lines on this test. And if you're negative, we'll just have one line and you're good to go.
Rapid tests have been in use for months in schools and the workplace. And in the weeks and months to come, they'll be a staple in your home medicine cabinet.
If you do it right, they're highly accurate and very, very good at detecting infections that can be transmitted to other people.
But will the at-home versions hold up to the sneaky Omicron variant that's figured out a way to evade some of the most sensitive tests, even lessened vaccine efficacy with changes to the spike protein? Unlike PCR testing that looks for actual DNA of SARS-CoV-2, rapid tests directly capture pieces of the virus, antigens. The most reliable tests detect what's called the nucleocapsid, an internal component of the viral particle.
That does not change as much with variants like Omicron, so rapid tests that are designed to capture the nucleocapsid are much less vulnerable to evasion by these variants like Omicron.
Think of the process like a common pregnancy test.
You swab your own nose or swab a child's nose, and you put the tip into a solution and into the cartridge or the card that carries the solution through a test strip. And if it comes up positive, there'll be a line that shows the presence of the virus in the sample.
It takes about 5 to 15 minutes to work. False positives are rare, but false negatives?
You can get false negative results because the antigen tests require more virus to detect. They're just not as sensitive as the PCR test. So you can be infected and get a negative result. But the good news is if you have a negative result and you are in fact positive, the amount of virus in your sample is so low that you're probably not very infectious to other people, assuming you did the test correctly.
And that was Dina Bearer reporting. Right now, at-home kits are difficult to find. Demand is high before all those holiday gatherings.
Yes, they are. But there are several rapid test manufacturers, including Abbott, based here in Chicago, that are working to replenish those supplies.
So you can actually go on Walgreens and CVS's websites, and it'll tell you by zip code which stores have those rapid tests in stock.
It's a great tool, yeah.
Not that I spent an hour yesterday at work doing that. Well, the owner of a missing